Good morning everyone, my name is Amitangshu and I work for an organization called AKVO. A quick introduction to what it is. AKVO is a non-profit foundation based in Amsterdam and we are not an acronym to mean water is the Esperanto language. I'm glad I'm in an audience where I don't have to explain what Esperanto language is. So that's a real pleasure. And the prime objective for organization is to make code data open, especially internationally. That's what we are going to work on. And we also develop open source mobile apps and tools for development sector. And AKVO is composed of 50% people who work in the water sector or the international development practice sector, and the rest are software developers. So I am a water sector person who is just trying to understand what Python and Java means. It's quite an arduous task. And the whole idea is to kind of bring quality tools to the development sector because that's what it lacks and it will benefit immensely from it. We are looking at large amounts of data collection which could be made open. It's a major need, one of our priority concerns. And of course, there's data that has to be also released at an aggregated level because a lot of data we collect is at a household level. So we're trying to work things out, and when we want to ask people to collect data and publish it, we're definitely on that path. We just need to find out the right platforms and ways of doing it. As of now, we have already collected with our systems something around 800,000 plus data using mobile tools, and we are going to hit a million mark very soon. The starting point of the presentation is about data collection. And I think this kind of sums it up for us, that when you look at digital data collection, which is going to be the next big thing in terms of data collection, we are going to move into digital platforms. Digital data collection is not just about technology, it's more about the people who use and collect data. And that is where that is the fundamental premise that we like to start from, based on our experience. Because the whole data collection system that we're looking at, a lot of things that have not worked. And the first important point is that data collection has been seen as inefficient. Because data is collected in a system which is hierarchical, it's closed, and data always flows upward. It moves against gravity like one does. And as a result, people who collect data, in most cases, don't know what exactly they're doing. And just like there's a food chain, imagine a data chain, and the people in the lowest rung of it, in this chain, are the collectors. But the problem is the people who collect data are the most underinvested part of this chain. They are also the biggest thing. So we are creating a system of data, of open data or visualizations, on a system where the production process is quite weak. And that is something that often a lot of energy doesn't even go towards. The funny thing also has been the cost paradox. A lot of organizations, a lot of hunting organizations especially, they don't have data budgets. There are not much budget for data and monitoring. But they want high demand for impact, which creates a kind of a paradox for organizations, because you cannot show impact if you don't collect data, but there is no budget for it. And this kind of puts the whole thing in a bind. And the whole data collection system, from our experience, has been very episodic. If you look at the way data is collected at large scale, it is episodic, it's not regular. So what happens is a lot of cost and planning and all going for one big bang exercise, and after that nothing gets followed up after that. And the final point also is that this ecosystem in which data is produced. Let me give an example. When we were working in Bihar some time back, when I was with an organization called AKVO, we realized a lot depends on who's asking the question. If you are a data collector from an NGO and you ask a person, who does this hand pump belong to? The answer would be community. But if you are a government person going to collect data, and you ask the same question, the answer will be, it belongs to me, it's a privately owned hand pump. And the reason for this, there are no archives on the ground. And every response people give when you're collecting data is an attempt to create a new archive, because there's nothing there previously. So the people on the field level who generate data, who kind of give responses, are aware of these situations. They are very intelligent also, and they know how to engage with the data collection process. The other part of this ecosystem, and this is something that we were recently collecting data on, it struck me that the foreground is data collection, you know, the way it's supposed to be with a mobile device. But at the background, it comes up this question. And it's both ways. This is the fundamental problem with data collection that we are facing right now. People do not know why they're answering questions, they have their own agendas behind answering questions, And then the person is collecting data is kind of not really engaged with the process because doesn't understand where is it all heading. So I think the fundamental thing that needs to shift within data collection is the foregrounding of the means. If data is the end that we are looking at, quality data, the means are the collectors. And the collectors now need to come to the foreground rather than, you know, being at the background and being the weakest part of the chain. So this is something which some of our partners in to collect data in Sundarbans area, very tough area to work in. And we have been looking at how their ability to collect data can really get enhanced using tools and also from the fact that how data can be collected more effectively. The important term here is data skills. And I think not needs to be done in developing data skills in organization to engage with collection of data. So our key lessons from data collection using digital tools have been that they remain still a low investment priority. Technology has enabled phenomenal speed of data collection analysis, but the quality of the interaction still needs hard work. The point where two people come together and have their interaction, it has to be more than a mechanical process to kind of get to somewhere. And that part needs hard work, but what technology is enabling us is it's allowing data to go back to the point of production. Unless we make data producers a part of the consumption chain, where they are consumers of the data they are producing, we are not going to see really good quality data coming in. And what technology is enabling us with map stories, with visualization, is to take it back to the people who collect, who can then understand what it means. This is a quick example from a pretty remote place in Vanuatu, where we are working with the government of the Vanuatu for monitoring the water systems. And the first map you see is a baseline survey that was done of water systems. All the green ones tell you that the water systems are working fine. But with the use of mobile technology, when we managed to get the baseline data onto the phones, where their colleagues could go and update the data records on the phone itself, the data was significantly different when we looked at the monitoring data. The idea is that when this thing happened, and we were there at the point where people were talking about it, there was a lot of discussion about how could you call that system working if there was a leakage and there was water dripping. The whole idea was this has never happened before. People have never really managed to use the data they have created. And that completely changed the way they were looking at it. They understood that they had to have bigger ownership of the data they were collecting. It was not a casual exercise. So I think that is where, you know, digital technology and the use of data can actually lead to. And finally, yes, a classic photo from Saravana Bhavan, which is so unique to Delhi, is this. When you look at data tools, a lot of organizations want everything. Like they want data tools to be the everything that they need to manage data in an organization, to generating reports, to whatnot. The fact is you need one thing that fits into the overall architecture by which organization manages projects. But our expectations are problematic. I think that would be a key message to also, you know, take home, that we need something that fits into the thing rather than become overall overarching thing. So that's it from our end. Yeah. Thank you very much for your patience.